Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A fun-loving, daddy's girl, died after developing a severe alcohol problem following the death of her father. Suzanne West, 38, of Marple Bridge, Greater Manchester, died in hospital in January this year after being admitted following a series of alcohol-related seizures. The mother of two began to drink heavily following the death of her father in 2009, eventually becoming so dependent she lost her job and was prevented from contacting her children, an inquest heard. At one point Miss West, a university graduate, was drinking 150 units of alcohol a week, roughly the equivalent of 15 bottles of wine, and was eating so little she looked almost anorexic. Suzanne West, 38, of Marple Bridge, Greater Manchester, died in hospital in January this year after being admitted following a series of alcohol-related seizures. The mother of two began to drink heavily following the death of her father in 2009, eventually becoming so dependent she lost her job. Tests carried out after Miss West's death revealed she had suffered severe malnutrition and a tear to her trachea caused by a complication with a breathing tube. Speaking at the Stockport hearing, Miss West's brother, Lee, told how his sister had been very good at her job and was a lovely and friendly girl who was the life and soul of the party, but that their father's death had impacted her greatly. He said, "She was a daddy's girl and it really did affect her." Mr. West explained that while his sister had started drinking more, it was not obvious that she was alcohol dependent at the time. He continued, "She split with her partner not long after. It then became apparent that she had an alcohol dependency problem. When she tried to detox, that's when she got admitted to hospital." At one point Miss West, a university graduate, was drinking 150 units of alcohol a week, roughly the equivalent of 15 bottles of wine. She engaged with alcohol services on a number of occasions and was having difficulties with depression. Social services got involved and she spiraled downwards after she could not have contact with her children. She started a new relationship at some point with someone who also had alcohol dependency problems and did not really support her. Mr. West told how his sister had turned up to his daughter's birthday parties drunk and lost her job at a primary school. Miss West, pictured, had previously been admitted to hospital after swallowing painkillers and antidepressants and drinking two bottles of wine and four ciders. He added, "She would push away people sometimes. There were times when she wouldn't answer the phone, but then there were times when she would call in tears." Mr. West visited his sister in hospital after she was admitted on December 30th last year. He continued, "When I did see her, it was a shock. I have never seen her so thin or so gaunt. She had lost a lot of weight and it was clear that she had not been eating for a while. She looked almost anorexic. The hospital wristband would slide up and down her arm." Miss West's boyfriend told the inquest that she had been living with him in the month before she was admitted to hospital and that she had started to look very thin and frail. He said, "She said she was still eating and still drinking, but just said that she did not feel well. I asked her if she wanted to see a doctor a number of times, but she just said that she did not need to." The boyfriend said he believed the seizures were caused because she cut down her alcohol intake too quickly. He added, "She was keeping her family and friends away from her. Her mental health was bad. She seems to have just given up." The inquest heard Miss West had previously been admitted to hospital in 2014 after she swallowed painkilling tablets and antidepressants and drank two bottles of wine and four ciders. Hospital manager Ian Robinson, whose colleagues dealt directly with Miss West, told the hearing, "She said she had intended to die and regretted that it not being successful. She was drinking up to 150 plus units of alcohol per week. She had undertaken two detoxes in the past, but they had been unsuccessful and she planned to undertake another detox. Suzanne was referred to a number of services, but it was agreed that she would be discharged." The inquest heard how Miss West, pictured, had turned up to family parties drunk. The inquest heard how Miss West had been the life and soul of the party before her father's death in 2009. The hearing was told Miss West was offered 6 appointments with a psychological therapy service, and at the first consultation she said she started experiencing problems following the death of her father. She described having low moods and feeling panic, but said she had not had a drink for 6 months. She attended 3 of the appointments and was discharged, but was referred again when she was readmitted to hospital in 2016 after an overdose of tablets and drinking half a liter of vodka. Miss West, pictured, looked thin and frail prior to being admitted to hospital in December. The inquest heard how Miss West had pushed family and friends away through her drinking. She was offered a place on an anxiety management group, but she failed to attend. Mr. Robinson, who works for the Rapid Assessment, Interface and Discharge Mental Health Service, added, "The overdoses suggest that Suzanne was committing very dangerous life-threatening acts, but the reality is we see quite a large number of people coming through the doors at A&E. There is no recovery service available that can help all of the problems. Obviously a judgment was made, and there was evidence to suggest she was at that stage where she may have needed more help. The issue with alcohol is problematic. A person has to be willing to engage it with our service for it to be effective." Recording a short form conclusion, Coroner Rachel Galloway said, "Miss West was a very unwell lady who needed a lot of care. In her earlier life, she was a cheerful and happy lady who had two children. But it was in the last 10 years of her life since the death of her father that led to depression and low moods. It is very sad that she did develop these difficulties.